Benvenuti and Craig Lachlan with you. These are the four keys to the game.
For the Washington Capitals, Smart at the blue line. They've got to get it in. They've got to get it out in tonight's game. They can't lose 17. That's Kovalchuk for Atlanta. PK pressure. They've allowed just three power play goals early on and play tough in the corners. They've got to have Kabina, Hainsey, and Bergosian taking the body against the Caps forwards.
Referees tonight are Gord Dwyer and Kyle Raymond. The linesmen are Mark Perret and Scott Driscoll. We're so glad you've tuned in. Washington hits the road for these two games. They're in the white sweaters, and it is Atlanta in their alternate, their third jersey in red. Reasoner swiftly down the wing. From a severe angle, he throws it on through. Chopped back to center by David Steckel. And Zach Bogosian will reload for the Thrashers, who rely heavily upon some young talent this season.
They've got a real young defensive core, and because of that, they've played with a lot more energy. As you take a look at the Caps line formations tonight, notice Fair inserted into the lineup, a coin inserted into the lineup, some lineup changes for the Caps Boudreaux.
Thorburn in alone, back, big stop there. A sprawling Varlamov made the pad save as Chris Thorburn got loose.
That was an ugly play at the Caps' blue line. Nick was the only one back, stumbled a little bit. Thorburn in alone. I think he was surprised. Didn't really make a great move to move the netminder. Either that or Varley just didn't bite on anything. That looked routine from up here with that left toe.
One thing that we can say, Locker, when you make a fine early stop like that, Semyon Varlamov tested right out of the gate. Netminders tend to get anchored in real well and get off to strong starts. You'll have to be good against this man. Ilya Kovalchuk dumps it in from center. Varlamov playing it around a loose hockey stick there. Schubert keeps it alive at a point position. Off the ricochet, the Capitals corral. On a day when Alex Giroux and Keith Aucoin get back into Bruce Boudreau's lineup, so too does Sean Morrison, 26 in the white.
And because of those forward differential changes, that means Gordon's out and so is Semin.
Ovechkin's wrister was muffled by Schubert, a rugged customer on John Anderson's back line. The former Ottawa Senator. This is Schultz for Washington. Straight ahead and on target. Fair's in. Fair fires. He scores! Eric Fair off of a beautiful feed.
Well, that's what we expect from Eric Fair. That's the type of release and shot we've seen so often in the American Hockey League. An exchange of breakaways, and the Capitals have struck first. What a wonderful goal by the forward Eric Fair. Here's the one end. Here's the save on Varley. Look at Thorburn, Joe. Watch him go to his forehand. That's a nice stop. And then the nice pass up the seam. How about double nickel, Schulte? That's right on the tape in stride. And that is right under the bar, as clean as can be over that catching glove. Love the glove. Maybe I don't love it anymore, but that was a great shot by Eric Fair.
Eric Fair now in five seasons as a pro. Whenever the Caps have matched up with Atlanta, we've seen some of Fair's best work. A beautiful finish right there. Mark it down at 2:02. Caps on top on the road. Peverly for Atlanta. Pinned to the wall by Schultz. Pothier sends it on around, but not out. Popovic is there for the Thrash on a bang-bang centering play. Armstrong jammed it wide. Armstrong, Kane, and Peverly were excellent in a shootout loss in Montreal.
Yeah, well, what they do, they've got a lot of energy, good skaters, and they really take the body. Look for this young 18-year-old Kane to be a part of this hockey game. You're going to see a youngster playing with men, and he has been terrific early on for Atlanta.
Schubert loads it up. That one had some heat on it. Varlamov able to fight it away with a blocker.
That stung him a little bit, it looks like.
Giroux on the outlet to the captain, Chris Clark, streaking in. Clark with a backhander that went high, and then he took Pavlik off of his feet. Still a crowd near the Thrasher crease. Washington on top by one. Eric Fair has the early tally for DC. He cashed in four times against the Thrashers last season. White looking to Little, poke checked away, and this is offside against Atlanta. This was a pretty pass, was it not, Locker, from Schultz to find the streaking winger.
And you've got to find the player in stride. If he slows down, he's in trouble. Here's Schultze right up the gut between the defense. There was a bad line change by Atlanta. You see them coming on late, and that's a goal scorer's goal. Right over the catching glove and left shoulder of the goalie, Pavlik. And there you look at Eric Fair's numbers, but an even better pass from double nickel. Schultz getting involved in the offense here in the first period.
23-year-old Calgary native Jeff Schultz getting a sweater tonight on the back end for Washington. Tyler Sloan held out as a healthy scratch. Alexander Semin is missing from Washington's lineup. More on him throughout the night as Knubel hits the brakes. Mike Knubel working as a trio with Nick Backstrom and Alex Ovechkin. Backstrom finding Mike Green, who's way up on the play. Morrison gunned one wide. Even strength and five aside as Slava Kozlov tables this back onto the Washington half.
Well, I think this is what was concerning the Atlanta Thrashers. Remember, this is a team that's played just one time here on home ice. They opened up the season October 3rd, a 6-3 win. They've been on the road since, Joe, and they were concerned about their first game back. And we're seeing signs of that. Not real crisp to start this game. They will, however, go to a power play here to try to tie it up.
Brian Little got tripped up by Sean Morrison.
Yeah, Mo to the box. Here he is, a nifty move. Notice he got to the inside. And once a forward gets to the inside on a play, you're tough out of luck. And that's why Mo had to stick the stick in there. The Caps go to the PK here early on.
Atlanta's played six games. Have a look at those power play numbers. Number one on the circuit. Right off the draw chance, they score. A Finneganoff.
Well, we highlighted the other two Russians at the top of this show, Kovalchuk and Ovechkin for the Caps. Finneganoff's another guy, sort of an enigma. I mean, he's played in Buffalo his whole career, signed to a tryout agreement in September, and just like that, on a misplay off the faceoff there by the Capitals defenseman and forward. That was Langer letting the man through. The defense don't pick him up. They score on a lucky bounce, and a Finneganoff makes sure as he slides it five hole. Just like that, they've tied it up here in Atlanta.
30-year-old Russian with points in three of his last four outings. Didn't get very many goals last year. Six of them total, but two of them came against the Caps, and he's got one this evening. David Steckel's pass for Matt Bradley. Poke checked aside by Popovic. A heavy run to the end wall. Quinton Lang flushes it back towards Bradley, and he's arm-in-arm with Schubert as you can see them dig along the dash here. Moving towards a five-minute mark of this first, and there's another penalty call coming. This time, referee Dwyer Locker is going to say holding.
Yeah, and that's because the Capitals scrummed it up along the wall. So now their power play goes to work to a much-improved penalty-killing unit. There's Schubert working down low. Watch his left hand. Once you put your hand inside the guy's shoulder, you're donezie. Schubert off for a minor penalty. The Caps go to a power play. Holding is the call early on. Working the wall, so important against Atlanta and their D. They're much improved. They've got good size. You've got to use your quickness against their top six.
If you're a little late just tuning in with us on Comcast Sportsnet in HD, you see the Caps power play numbers. Ovechkin with a bullet right to the shoulder of Pavlik, and then he got a quick whistle for the stoppage in play. Fair from Schultz, a Finneganoff from Antropov, and those two markers separated by just a little over 2 minutes.
Take a look at those numbers there, the Caps power play. The power play, however, on the road has been very solid. 4 of 12 for this Caps team and Alex Ovechkin. Alex Ovechkin, of his 9 goals to date, just one have come with the extra man. They've spread the wealth around on the power play. Once he gets charged up with the extra man and gets 10 to 20, maybe more than that this year, you'll see the type of numbers he's going to have.
Capitals had won 5 of the first 6 faceoffs this evening. Brooks Like did not corral that one. Colby Armstrong didn't get it out. Mike Green puts it back on the blade of Backstrom. The give for Like on the rotation play. Ovechkin overran it. And Washington will have to give chase.
That was a nice rotation, Joe. The one thing they got lucky was Atlanta is that puck hit off the knee of Hainsey as he was going down to block the pass, and that misplayed by Ovi.
Backstrom to the front, padded away by Pavlik. The graphic showed you the turnaround in the special teams work for this particular unit, the PK group. And John Anderson said they spent a lot of time in the summer on this.
Started in August. They went through a lot of tapes from a lot of different teams in the NHL reviewing penalty killing. It was one area that was mandated that they've got to get better on. Coming into this game, just three power play goals scored against Atlanta. They've been more aggressive, plus they have two distinct units that have stayed together.
Nice look here for Knubel. He fumbled it for just a second. That stopped him from pulling the trigger. Ovechkin hesitates along the wall, chased by Reisner. Green back for Ovechkin. No one-timer there. It's loose in front. Pinballs around, and Pavlik makes the save, and he will cover.
Love the traffic by Knubel and the guys in white here to start this hockey game. They look hungry around the crease. Pavlik, solid start to this game. He's a big rig that goes to the butterfly, takes up a lot of space of that 6x4 cage. You don't have a lot of room. Rebounds are going to be critical for Fair, Clark, and company off the initial shots from the points tonight.
Let's see what Brendan Morrison can do as we watch from our Hooters face-off angle. A clean win for the Thrashers and an easy exit. With just 30 seconds left on the Washington power play, Ovechkin finding Brendan Morrison. Didn't shovel it through Pavel Kubina. Kubina said to us today that the penalty killing's been very, very aggressive. As Ovechkin hits the brakes inside for Brendan Morrison, and that one caroms wide. Morrison tied up by Kubina. Ovechkin that way for Green. His wrister was muffled by Hainsey and off of the rink.
And see the what happens when you're aggressive, Joe. That's a perfect example right on your cue. Just the way they made the Capitals move the puck to the outside. That means you're aggressive. Once you're allowed to move it to the inside, you're a more passive penalty kill. You look at Booter's numbers through three seasons with the Caps, closing in on 100 wins as the bench boss.
Washington wins this draw. Pothier force-feeding Matt Bradley. The youngster Bogosian was right there. We asked Bruce Boudreau why Atlanta's off to such a good start, and he had a pretty simple answer. They've got better players this year, he said.
I thought Don Waddell did a great job in the offseason. You look at Kubina, you look at Antropov, guys like that, and plus the maturity of their young guys. I mean, look at Bogosian. I mean, he's going to be a stud if he isn't already, and he's not even 20, I don't think, yet.
And already an alternate captain. It is Bogosian rushing the puck here, ran right into Jeff Schultz, and Schultz will spill it back to center. There's Enstrom. His lead is off target. Flutters right to Varlamov, who boxed it into the corner. Back to five-on-five hockey as we near the eight-minute mark of the opening period. Eric Fair first on the board for Washington. Maxim Afanasyev has countered for Atlanta. There's the handoff for Popovic and the reverse quickly for Schubert. Using the glass to get it to center. Antropov opening up. He's right on in. Leaves it to the trailer. Popovic's blast was blocked as a coin was back-checking in a hurry. Schubert settles and fires a pad save for Varlamov. Capitals have the rebound. Alexander Giroux's feed down the wing for Chris Clark.
And you can see what they now bring. Atlanta has much more firepower from the blue line.
A coin on a pump fake. Giroux backside. He scores! Alex Giroux.
Great chemistry there between a coin and Giroux. They played together for so many years in the American Hockey League with the Hershey Bears. And there you see the sixth sense, the ability to pick up a line mate that you have comfort with. And a coin, just a nice seam pass that opens up to Giroux, a guy that I said has to be a factor in this game. They're looking for secondary scoring, the Caps. Giroux, left side of the screen, fake shot, freezes everybody. Clark goes to the net, which is not going to be overlooked, Joe. He goes to the net, which takes Popovic back, which opens up that seam to make the pass.
You always talk Great about play. That center lane yep. drive, and Chris Clark doing just that to open it up for Alex Giroux, who had a couple of goals on Saturday night for the Hershey Bears against Binghamton. There he pots his first in the NHL this season, giving Boudreau and the Caps the one-goal advantage back.
And it just shows you the importance of moving the puck side to side against big, good goalies. You've got to make the move. That one right under the pads of Pavlik, and the Caps have a lead and will be going to the power play.
Backstrom with a wrister that was stopped. Pavlik to the splits. Score! Right around the crease, Knubel gets rewarded on a juicy rebound.
So much for the delayed penalty coming up against Atlanta. It'll be washed out. The Caps will have a two-goal lead here in the first period. The first period for the Caps has been great this season. They've now outscored the opposition 14-3, and it's Knubel's hard work. Finally puts it in when he's on his keister, and the Caps have a two-goal lead. Going to the net, net presence, probably went off that left leg also. That could go to review upstairs.
Uh-oh.
It wasn't the foot, though. It was the knee. It must be a distinct kicking motion to propel the puck into the net, and I'm saying this goal is going to stand here in the first period.
If it does, it would come just 16 seconds after the Giroux tally. John Anderson will wait for this one to be reviewed. It goes right through to Toronto. They make the decisions as to whether or not Washington has a 3-1 lead.
Varley was just getting to the bench when the Caps had their sixth forward there on the delayed penalty. But Knubel, has he ever made his mark here in Washington, coming over from the Flyers as an unrestricted free agent in the summer months? An overhead look as Gabby and Woodsy takes a look. Here's the shot. Right toe, follow up, Knubel, one shot, right there, gets a piece of it, then falls down as he's tripped up, and there goes that left leg, and the puck is propelled into the net, Joe.
Referee Gord Dwyer quickly to the telephone. Knubel, last year while he was with the Philadelphia Flyers locker, had great success against Atlanta. In four games, he scored five times. He thinks he's got one right now. It has to be approved by the review officials in Toronto.
If it doesn't count, the Caps will be on their power play. As you look at the goalie, Pavlik getting the nod ahead of Lettinen. His backup tonight is Hedberg. Lettinen surgery in the offseason once again. He seems to be a young goaltender that is never healthy.
They're going to wash this out.
Wow.
No goal.
That's surprising. I thought that was just momentum of him falling towards the net that pushed that puck in with that leg, Joe.
Locker, I thought that overhead view that we shared, you may appreciate the forward motion of the skate. Whoops.
Oh, yeah. That's the view.
That's the one. And now Washington should have the power play. Is that not correct?
Yes, they should. Should have one right now.
And Atlanta will have to convert down to four men on ice as Colby Armstrong gets a little lecture. Washington's lead is just one. The Knubel tally overturned after video review, and rightfully so, after that last look that we shared. And now the penalty does kick in on Colby Armstrong.
They got it right, Joe. I got it wrong. It's definitely a kick. Caught right in that skate boot and right behind the goaltender.
So the Capitals will get their second power play chance of this opening period. Think back to their win over Nashville when they were 1-for-3. These power play stats that are packaged by the UPS store. Washington with goals from Giroux and Fair. Atlanta has one from Afinagenov. First of six meetings between these Southeast Division rivals. Like scampers into the offensive zone. Left it along the boards and it clicked off of Thorburn. Back on Washington's side of center. Mike Green's got points in three straight games. Green hustles back through center and lobs it into the corner.
He told me this morning, everything's feeling more comfortable, Joe. His hockey stick, his gloves, everything is correct now. He feels very good his last couple of games.
Is that before or after you had the lengthy conversation about performance automobiles?
No, that was after I talked, before I talked about his Lambo, yes.
Uh-huh. Ovechkin maneuvers in at the line. Attacked there by Bogosian, who makes the takeaway. And now he'll streamline back two on two. Evander Kane with a wrister that went wide. A 19-year-old to an 18-year-old. Amazing that they can perform at the level they do here in the NHL. Nearing the midway mark of the opening period with the Caps on top by one and still a man to the good for 40 seconds. That left in the sentence on Colby Armstrong. Papier, a former Thrasher, bangs it into the corner. Brendan Morrison with a wrister, and Pavlik got those arms to the body there. Ovechkin off the wall to Fair. Badgered by Reisner. Hainsey on the interrupt. And with Reasoner's help, Atlanta clears.
Well, you can see the two distinct units and notice that the coach, Anderson, has been changing them up quickly. He utilizes two or three sets of forward units, and he's rolled them against this Caps power play, which allows you to be aggressive. When you're tired, you're not going to be aggressive. The Caps haven't hemmed them in yet on this power play.
Tom Pody dancing with it at the line, throws it to the front. It winds up on Kane's blade. Evander Kane trying to spring Armstrong just out of the box as Atlanta is back to even strength. Washington with just one shot on that last failed power play. Overall for the game, Washington and Atlanta tied up at six apiece unofficially on the shot scoreboard. Back through center, Bradley keeping a close eye on Peverly, and Milan Urcina goes the other direction.
Well, this is an Atlanta Thrashers team that has been badly outshot, even though they have a nice record coming into tonight. 211 to 146, show in shots. So they give up opportunities. If they continue with that type of play, the Caps are going to be able to jump on them here in Atlanta.
Did I see it right? They've been outshot Locker in every game this
year.
Yes,
right on.
And still 4-1-1 against 4-2-2 Washington. A scramble in the high slot, bounce free to Slava Kozlov, and he'll clear. Kozlov was assessed a major for checking from behind in overtime in Montreal, but no subsequent suspension.
Wasn't it Gomez? He crossed tight to the boards. They were thinking there could be a game suspension or two levied against Kozlov, but they deemed it a non-penalty. They gave him a five-minute major, and that was enough. No suspension whatsoever.
Most importantly, Atlanta could not use Kozlov in a shootout, which ultimately decided the game, and he's very good at that. Sean Morrison ushers it down the wing on through Acoin. Acoin set up Giroux beautifully at the eight-minute mark. That's given Washington the advantage as we have just about 8 minutes to go in period one.
I would have just given him a one-gamer so he couldn't play tonight.
That would have been nice for the Caps.
Yeah, he always seems to play very well against this Caps team.
Such a heady hockey player. Kovalchuk and Ovechkin were shoulder-to-shoulder there for a second. Antropov intercedes for Atlanta, as Schubert has all sorts of running room now. Straight ahead for Antropov. Down the dasher, it's a Finneganov. Tried to make one more pass, and then Pody closed ranks on him. Alex Ovechkin, tremendous numbers against Atlanta in his career.
Best against any team, and for Atlanta, the three Russians put together tonight. They flipped lines a little bit compared to what they used the first part of this season. The three Russians are together to start this game tonight against
the Caps. John Anderson, Locker, trying to get Brian Little going a little bit.
He was a big gunner last year. Big-time numbers for Little. He had 31 goals.
None so far. As Pody looks up ice, saucers this one on one big skip to Knubel. That was onside. To the front, nobody home there, save for Hainsey of Atlanta. Armstrong taps it on through. Peverly could not latch onto it as Schultz propels it back in deep for Washington. Caps on top by one with 6:45 separating us from a NetStar One intermission report on Comcast Sportsnet tonight. So glad you've tuned in there with us. Joe Beninati and Craig Lachlan with you from Phillips Arena in Atlanta.
By the way, absolutely no breaks yet
nope.
in this first period.
On and on we go.
Yeah.
And our commercial sponsors suffer. Trust me, we'll make it up to you. As Kubina connects with Armstrong for a blast that was blocked. Kane, good move off the wall. Evander Kane for Colby Armstrong. Peverly is next in line. Stopped by Varlamov, and he will cover. Harsh words exchanged in front, but cooler heads are going. Let's see. The conversation would be, I'll root for your team if you root for mine. Caps have a 2-1 advantage in Atlanta. Toyota ones to watch. These two have done great damage against the other's squad.
Alex Ovechkin, 23 goals and 30 versus Atlanta. Kovalchuk, 22 and 42 versus Washington are Toyota's ones to watch. I had picked Giroux and Fair, but I decided at the last minute to chase to these guys.
It's amazing how clairvoyant you can be sometimes. Good call by you. Atlanta wins this draw. Enstrom fires, and that hit traffic in front. Brian Pothier pouncing on it for D.C. They're dressed in white on the road tonight with the Thrashers, and then again on Saturday against the New York Islanders. We'll see Scott Gordon's squad on Comcast Sportsnet.
Another good young player there, huh, Joe? John Tavares got the shootout winner last night against Carolina.
Brooks like throws a stiff arm out. Fair tried to feather it through. Bogosian, no sale. 5:40 to go in the opening stanza. Fair posted up along the boards. Brendan Morrison's look, that's deflected away, and Schultz will give chase. Connecting at center with Fair, he sprinkles it for Brendan Morrison. Like loads it up, and that was swallowed up by Schubert. Bogosian will turn. More and more ice time, more and more responsibilities for that youngster.
And he's still got to learn, I think, and part of his game is to rein some of the rushes in. He's got to pick his spots, and that's something that the staff is working on him this season. Doesn't have to be a rusher all the time. You've got to pick your spots, and he still has to crush guys because he's very mobile and an excellent body checker.
15 minutes in, and alert Caps fans, I'm sure, have seen no Alex Semin on the ice tonight for Washington. He was sick, and now Bruce Boudreau says he's sore.
The double S.
And out of the lineup. 2-1 for Washington. We'll get you back to Dixie in
Same
a moment.
Same thing, I am with you.
Yeah, I know. You're sick and tired, though. Capitals closer and closer to some good news on Tomas Fleischmann.
Yeah, he started to practice Tuesday and Wednesday. No contact, not eligible to play until the Flyer game Tuesday at Verizon Center. They'd love to have his secondary scoring back. He had a career-high 19 goals. All smiles when you get to practice with the team, not by yourself, which he has been doing. Flash, I have to tell you this, though. Giroux and Fair are playing tremendously. You may not get back in the lineup.
They hear the footsteps then, huh?
Sure, he's watching at home, too.
Yeah, still no contact for Flash. Yeah. As this one's deflected about four rows into a souvenir country. Friends, you can head to Verizon Center. Caps are tangling with Philadelphia next week, Tuesday the 27th. And the Islanders come in for a visit on Friday the 30th. Tickets are limited. Call 202-397-SEAT. So this Southeast Division game, and then right back into the Atlantic. First game inside the division for the Capitals. It, what, ties the latest into a new season that it took them to square off with a division foe.
And against the division last year, they were very solid. They were 16-8 in overall, 4-2 against this Atlanta team. They'd like to get up, stay up, and win the Southeast Division once again.
Washington two-time defending champs in that bracket.
Atlanta has won it once.
Back in 07, and then it was a quick exit from the postseason for them, if I remember correctly.
Rangers.
Four straight.
Yeah.
Backstrom, hiding at center, coughed it up. Todd White motors in. White finding the late guy, Hainsey, joined there by Kozlov, and he backhanded one wide. Slava Kozlov, 13 in red. Off the wall for White. Poke check by Backstrom. Knubel trying to golf it out. Mike Knubel had a goal overturned by video review, or else DC would have been up by two. Little pitched it for Kubina. That was stopped in front as Varlamov was screened. Little gets it back. Plays the cycle game for Kozlov. On top to Kubina. Long wrister is wide. Little to the front. That aerial goes unanswered, and Ovechkin goes the other way. Knubel late in his line shift will dump it in. Bruce Boudreau wants to get some fresh folks out there. Bogosian will wait. Trained in high school a little bit by Ray Bourque, is that right?
Yeah, Cushing Academy, where Ray's both his kids went to, and Ray was often an assistant coach, a helper on the ice. Obviously, you see some of the offensive things that he's taught this youngster.
Kovalchuk explodes down the wing, looks for a Finneganoff, that caroms in, stopped by Varlamov. Follow-up, they score. Ilya Kovalchuk.
Well, he might like what he sees from the Russian three. Well, the head coach, John Anderson, Ilya gets his eighth goal of the season. We highlighted the top two Russians in the NHL at the top of the show. Kovalchuk, the puck finds you. Look at the Caps can't clear. There's the bad clearing attempt right up the middle. Looked like the Caps had it for a fraction of a second. Watch what happens. Here's the shot. There's a good back check. Watch in front. Looks like a coin. Tries to clear it, but he clears it right up the gut. And it goes right on the stick of their captain, Ilya. A great start. Captain Covey in Atlanta has tied it up.
At 17:02 with his eighth of the season. High scoring again between these two clubs. In every game last year, all six regular season meetings, at least one team deposited four goals or more. We get a whistle here and a penalty. Young referee Kyle Raymond making the assessment. It's a boarding call to come. We are deadlocked at 2 from Phillips Arena on CSN. Capitals Vice President and General Manager George McPhee looking on from on high. 2-2 Caps and Thrashers in Atlanta, and the GM made a little move for conditioning for Michael Nylander.
Yeah, Michael agreed to go to Grand Rapids in the American Hockey League. 3 games in 3 days this weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Has not played a game this season. Over 900 career games, close to 800 points for Michael. And I think this is a positive development in the Nylander saga. Number one, he agreed to go, which he has to under the collective bargaining agreement. And number two, that may mean there could be some interest around the NHL for Michael Nylander's services. They want to see how this guy's going to play at the American Hockey League level and see what he's still got to play in the NHL.
Evander Kane gone for boarding, so Washington has the power play. And the Caps have a lot of prospects at center in Hershey. Guys like Wilson and Perreault and Beagle and Jodry, and they want him to play, so not the best spot for Michael down in Hershey, but better served in AHL and Grand Rapids.
And Grand Rapids was needing players. They're the affiliate of the Detroit Red Wings, not reading into anything into that just because it's the Red Wings affiliate, but they're going to give him an opportunity, and I think it's a positive development, Joe. It could mean there are some suitors that want to see him play. You know, he probably will never play for the Caps this season, so they've got to try to move him.
Brendan Morrison gains the center stripe. Colby Armstrong was waiting. 2 minutes away from a NetStar One intermission report are we on Comcast Sportsnet. Caps and Thrashers are equal at 2 apiece. Backstrom down the wing for Knubel, canceled out by Schubert. Bogosian is there. Right to awaiting Brendan Morrison to the front, and Backstrom blasted it wide.
A real bad play by the youngster Bogosian. Too soft along the wall, especially when you're penalty killing. It's got to be hard and firm to get it out.
Peverly with the intercept, and he'll clear it ahead. Armstrong one-on-one, and Ovechkin comes to get him with 90 seconds left in the opening period. Ovechkin full blast through center. Ovechkin lost it on the cradle. Right to awaiting Chris Clark for a backhander. Pad save Pavlik. And Thorburn, who's never been a penalty killer until this year, motors down the wing. Backhands one wide of Varlamov.
Got a good set of wheels tonight.
He can skate, and he's a big guy. Mike Green clamps on for Washington, looking for an outlet. He coughed it up. And Hainsey sends it back into Varlamov's neighborhood with a minute to go in period one.
No time for this Caps power play. Talk about aggressive. We've talked about that improvement. Fourth best in the National Hockey League. And you see why. I thought in years past they've been too passive. They've changed the scheme of the penalty killing, and it's worked out perfectly for John Anderson.
Brooks Like leaves it in the corner for Chris Clark. Clark contained there by Peverly. Clark around a pick set by Fair. Lost the handle. Fair gets it back for Washington with 25 ticks in the period. Loose to the front. Pavlik, a stick save. Enstrom keeps it along the boards, and White will get it out. Does it have enough starch for an icing? Not quite. As Steckel will clear it on down. 8 seconds left. Along the boards, Antropov. 3 seconds to work. Lang looks up and fires one on its bumpy way, and Pavlik boots it aside. We are done with one in Atlanta and tied up at 2 apiece. Thrashers, very mild temperatures outside of Phillips Arena. We're done with one, with the Caps and Thrashers tied up at 2. And here's your scoring summary.
Fair from Schultz, Afinagenov from Antropov on the faceoff. Giroux on a wonderful pass from McCoin. Kovalchuk from Antropov and Afinagenov. So Max, a goal and an assist. And this is a guy, Kovalchuk, Joe, you look at the numbers in the first period, just over 3 minutes of work. Alex Ovechkin and the Caps, the most of anybody, over 10 minutes of ice time in the first 20 minutes.
Over the last 5 years combined, Kovalchuk and Ovechkin, top two among goal scorers in the NHL. Kovalchuk has his so far. We wait for the grade eight. Steckel's pass looking for Matt Bradley. He was defended pillar to post by the tough guy there in the Atlanta lineup.
So-called fourth line against fourth line. The home team has the last change. So when the Caps threw out their Steckel line, out come Bolton and their tough line.
Bolton, Reisner, and Thorburn out there in red. Thrasher's wearing their alternate sweaters. Bradley has this for Washington in white. Bradley turns the cage, swivels back, and then fans with Enstrom drawing a bead on him. First minute of the second period, even strength. There's Pody for Yurchina, and that missile went wide. Milan Yurchina, along with Tomas Fleischmann and assistant coach Dean Evison, they're going to visit Lake Ridge Middle School on Monday in Woodbridge, Virginia, doing a little community service.
Yeah, and let's take a look at some more stuff. We got to look at our Toyota League leaders. Most goals allowed last season. The Maple Leafs still doing it this year. The Thrashers have tightened it up under John Anderson. Islanders, Lightning, Avalanche, all teams that couldn't keep the puck out of their net.
Backstrom hesitates on Bogosian. Thorburn comes to lend some defensive support.
I think a lot of that for Atlanta, though, was inconsistent goaltending, Joe. They didn't get the top-notch goaltending that you need in this day and age.
I thought Kari Lehtinen was pretty good in the second half last year. Lehtinen not in the Atlanta lineup. Still bothered by a back injury.
I still think, though, because of all his injuries and his inconsistencies, Pavlik may be their guy of the future. I think they're holding out for this guy, and that's why he's going to get a ton of time. I'm not so sure that Lehtinen's going to be the number one guy anymore.
Kovalchuk sprints in and fires. That's deflected. Semyon Varlamov in the nets for Washington. We expect Jose Theodore to go on Saturday night when the Caps match up with the Islanders for the first time this fall.
For Varley, the most wins of any netminder in their rookie season this year. He's already got three on his slate.
Finneganov brushed it right to a waiting Pody. Now ahead to Knubel. Drops it off for Ovechkin. That combination passing play deflected away by Hainsey. And we stay 2-2 early in period two. And these Atlanta Thrashers, they've had some opportunities to pick very high in the draft.
Yeah, Stefan, I'm not sure if that was a great pick back in 99.
Oops.
Heatley, a big-time pick. Kovalchuk, Lehtinen, Bergoshin, Kane. The last five, pretty special, and are going to be here for a long time.
Evander Kane, such a very good skater. Brooks Like right there. Trickles one to the front. Peverly was on guard. This is Kane, nine in the red. Such a
right
great skater. And he wipes out. Kane bounces back up. Gave it up to Brooks Like, and he'll trickle one to neutral ice.
His dad, who trains him in the summer on and off the ice, including some boxing because he was an amateur boxer and a hockey player at St. Evex, a college team in Canada, worked out with his son all summer long. Does a lot of power skating, and that's why you see that speed from number nine.
Evander Kane. There's a boxing reference there, too, isn't there?
Evander Holyfield, named after him because his dad was an avid amateur boxer.
Tried to touch this one on for Armstrong. Sean Morrison playing catch through with Brendan Morrison there, defended by Popovic. Armstrong ahead, Schubert the other way for the Thrashers, who will be content to dump it in. All the scoring in the opening period. Fair and Giroux for Washington. Finneganov and Kovalchuk for the homestanding Thrash. As this one's touched up, it's an icing call against the Capitals.
Well, it looks like we can see the matchup that you're looking at tonight. He's really matching lines as John Anderson against the Caps and Giroux, one of the goal scorers, and something that the Caps desperately need. He's got his top three Russians against the Ovechkin line. So it's power against power as you look at his career totals.
Chris Clark on the accelerator, softly to the front. Pavlik, native of the Czech Republic, able to get that one out. As the Capitals rewind quickly, Bogosian and Enstrom, who should be on the Atlanta back line for many, many years to come. Enstrom didn't handle that pass cleanly. Giroux.
That wasn't a good pass, though.
To a coin. Swing and a miss on the one-timer, and now Pothier will have to give chase. An ice level look at the veteran blue liner who began his career in the NHL with these Thrashers. A coin has some running room. To the front, a timing play, a bit strong for Ovechkin. There's Clark, muscled by Kubina. Pothier winds and drives. That was quieted by Kozlov. Ovechkin's cut down. Power play for the Caps soon to come. Varlamov on his way to the bench. Ovechkin at the midpoint sends it on the way. It's loose there, and the whistle comes in front of Pavlik.
And I think it's going to be the big rig, Kabina, heading off on a tripping minor. Pavel Kabina, a big rig, but got his stick cut underneath of Ovi's skates as he moved laterally across the top of the circles. There's 77 heading off. Alex Ovechkin, some good opportunities. Here you'll take a look at an isolation here on Comcast Sportsnet of Alex Ovechkin. There's that quick move. Notice how quick he is to get at full speed. That quickness, that stutter step, forces Kabina to take that tripping minor.
Power play stats that are packaged by the UPS store. Washington 0 for 3. The Devils are the only team this fall to keep Washington off with respect to a power play goal per game. Backstrom waiting along the half wall, playing catch with Green. Shaded there by Reisner. Brendan Morrison for Green. Now Ovechkin back through the scene to Brendan Morrison.
I thought he was shooting that one, Joe. It didn't look like a pass. It looked like it rolled right off the end of his stick.
Wasn't very effective either way.
No.
As Green carefully finds Ovechkin. He gets it into the Atlanta zone. Bogosian takes it away from Backstrom and sends Washington packing. Just past the five-minute mark, still scoreless in the second, tied up at two, these two Southeast Division rivals. Brendan Morrison lost his balance. Nick Backstrom takes it from a severe angle. On the interchange with Ovechkin. Elevates it for Green. Inside to Knubel. One more to Brendan Morrison. That was poked away. Peverly didn't get it out. Green anticipated that.
That was ugly. He's got to be more powerful than that.
Brendan Morrison to the front off of Pavlik, who can't sight the rebound. Waiting for him at the doorstep. Knubel had to give ground because his stick was broke. Ovechkin fires, just missed. The ricochet is chased down by Green. Power play another 24 seconds. Fair unloads high and wide.
There is sticks everywhere around the net, one behind the net, including something else, another stick at the circle also.
Truly a yard sale out there.
Yeah, it's just not in sync, the power play, Joe. I'm not sure if it's the pressure of the penalty killing unit or it's just one of those nights. They don't seem as crisp as we have seen them early on this season.
Officials helping pick up some of the litter as Hainsey.
There's also a helmet in the corner.
Ilya Kovalchuk blasting down the wing. Backhands it off the outside of the cage. Chris Clark didn't get it through Hainsey on the first try. Washington back through neutral now with Fair in charge. A good wrister that went high and wide. And then Pavlik stopped the backhand rebound. Like posted up behind the net. Five-on-five play here as Antropov, a towering winger, takes Like into the corner, and there they go around the empty or broken sticks and empty helmets.
Yeah, had to get around everything in that corner. Tough to cycle around some trash to the left of the goalie.
And thank goodness the helmets are empty. You don't want any heads in those. 2-2 in Atlanta.
Game's tied up. That late goal in the first period. Kovalchuk on the board for the Atlanta Thrashers, getting some ice time here in the second, more so than in the first.
Ilya Kovalchuk, number one Atlanta all-time. Goals, assists, points, power play goals, games played. Shall I continue? He's going to hold every record here for quite a while. That is,
if they sign him.
If they get him under contract, correct?
Well, they're trying to all season long. Donnie Waddell has had conversations with his agent. Obviously, they want to get him locked up. He's going to be seeking somewhat in the range of an Alex Ovechkin. I mean, for John Anderson in this franchise, I think he is the ultimate. They have to sign him. Could be 10 to 15-year deal, $7, $8, $9, or $10 million a year for Kovalchuk.
Yurchina through the screen. That was deflected away. Bogosian sends it on out there for a Finneganoff, one of the two Atlanta scores back in the opening period. Ilya had the other. Fair and Giroux have fired for Washington.
Finneganoff, a bargain for this Thrasher team. As a tryout in September, made it. Signed for $800,000, Joe.
It's a good deal.
Very good deal.
For a player who's been an enigma, however, yeah, you have to say.
Absolutely. Sometimes he's on, other days he's not, and that's why Lindy Ruff had him in the doghouse last year, and that's why he was injured, he was banged up, and only got a handful of goals. He's usually a 20-goal guy, and that's what they need here in Atlanta.
He looks like a Pavel Bure clone, but he doesn't produce like him. Kovalchuk puts it out there. Finneganoff sends in Andropov, holding. He was interfered and fouled on his way to the cage. So Atlanta gets the power play.
It's not the Russian five here in Atlanta. It's the Russian three doing some damage. That's some nice passing between the two blue lines. And passing is faster than how you can skate when you move the puck. And this is tape to tape. Look at the rewind. Nice little pass. Kovalchuk up to Finneganoff, into the seam to Andropov. And he drives the center lane. And there's the hook and hold from behind. Yurchina in the box. Power play. Thrashers.
Thrashers only needed about 5 seconds to produce on the power play back in the first. They win the draw again as Kovalchuk settles those power play stats that are packaged by the UPS store. Atlanta 27% effective against Washington last year. Kozlov to the front. It clicked off of Schultz. Varlamov alertly watched it go wide. Up close and personal in the corner. Kozlov puts it back to point position. Kovalchuk takes. Steps to a better shooting angle. Had it blocked by the long reach of David Steckel. Quentin Lang in a tussle with White. Thrasher still keep it alive. Enstrom slowing the pace. Kovalchuk one-timer stopped by Varlamov as that was tipped out of midair, too.
That was a real heavy, hard shot, which Kovalchuk brings to the table. He's ultimately the finisher on the power play. The setup guy is Kozlov. He had 43 points on the power play, second most in the National Hockey League. The power play goes through him, but finishes with number 17.
That was a good save for Varlamov because it took Atlanta nearly 9 minutes to get their first shot of the period. A Finneganoff sweeps it along the base of the boards. Enstrom, the Swedish-born blue liner, puts it below the goal line. Sean Morrison entangled with a Finneganoff. Bradley for Sean Morrison, and away go the Thrashers.
And when you watch practice this morning, you're surprised at the size of some guys in height and strength and width. But I was surprised in the size of Enstrom. Not that big, Joe.
Oh, he's listed at 5'10",
and that's
generous.
Yeah.
As Pody crunches one all the way down the pond. Moving towards the midway mark of regulation, all the scoring in the first period. As we're with you on Comcast Sportsnet, thrilled to be in HD tonight. Caps and Thrashers. First of six, and the first three of those six are played here. Thrashers don't come to D.C. until February. Schultz, arm-in-arm with Andropov. Nice take up and again off, and it's jammed wide by Kubina, who has a howitzer of a shot.
And he's great on the power play. Last year, 14 goals. He led the Leafs with 9 power plays, Joe, so he's always a threat with the extra man.
Oh, look at this! From way downtown, a very generous skip, and the Caps lead.
Bounce right in front of the net and right over that catching glove. We said one of the keys to the game is love the glove. Well, there, that one gets away from him. Hainsey talking to his netminder. The Caps will jump on this and take the lead 3-2. Anderson can't believe it. One of those things that happens, Schultz and the Caps happy. Here comes Schultze. Here comes the shot. There it gets nicked a little bit, but watch the bounce at the end. It could be Knubel that's going to get credit for this, Joe. Both Knubel and Hainsey looked like one of those two guys got a piece of it, but it was that weird bounce in front or the goalie has it.
Such an innocent-looking stretch play, and it yields big dividends for Washington. Jeff Schultz sent it on the way. It looked like it hopped near the blade of Mike Knubel and then bad hopped Pavlik into the goal.
Give it to him. He's missed one already today, waved off.
Trust me, middle infielders in the World Series don't want to have one skip like that to come. Thorburn back to point position. Bogosian fanned. Hainsey won't. That's knocked down by Varlamov.
And notice where it was knocked down. That shows aggressive goaltending by Varley. That means he's on top of his game. He was way out above any type of pressure from the Atlanta Thrashers in front of the net. That was the best save of the game for Varley.
In-house here at Phillips Arena, they are crediting Jeff Schultz with the marker at 10:20 as it is touched up by Popovic. It's an icing call against Washington, and Semyon Varlamov will get the assist on that lengthy, and I do mean lengthy, goal.
Yeah, it went from Varley to Schultz, I thought it was still deflected in the neutral zone. Other than that, Schultz has his first goal, a 40-game goalless streak, plus an assist on a wonderful pass in the first.
Atlanta wins the draw, and that missile from Schultz was deflected off of the rink. The officials conferred and then got it right. It did hop up into that safety netting. 8:42 to go in the second period. A strange goal giving the Great Eight and the Caps the lead.
Nice rink in the NHL is 200 feet. The Caps have taken the lead. Both these guys get a point. Varley's got his first assist. Schultz has got a goal. Watch this. The rink's 100 or 200 feet long. We think this is about 160 or more. Here's the bounce. Double skip, but watch this one in front of the net right there. Unlucky for the goalie. Caps lucky, and the Caps have the lead. Schultze gets credit for a goal and also has an assist in the first, a two-point night for the Capitals defender.
Beautiful job by the camera crew, tape operators to capture that. We thank all the men and women in our crew tonight at Phillips Arena in Atlanta on Comcast Sportsnet. Schultz fires one more conventionally. Rebound, score! Matt Bradley!
Schultze looking like Larry Murphy back there, Joe.
He's got 3 points.
Yeah. Unbelievable stepping in, but that's all Steckel. Steckel was being pushed off by the left defender, and instead of just dumping it in, when we watch the replay, he hooks off. When you hook off, you're able to find the late guys. Watch this. He's normally going to just dump it. Instead, he hooks off. There's the late guy not picked up. That starts the whole play. And then I told Brad's this morning with you standing there, I say, Brad's your Duke. Well, there he is, right on the doorstep. He gets his third of the year. Bradley and the Caps up by a pair.
Matt Bradley had never scored against the Atlanta Thrashers in better than 30 run-ins with them. He changes that tune. Two tallies, a minute, 14 seconds apart. And the Thrasher fans are giving Pavlik the what for. How fickle can they be? This guy's been dynamite in the first 3 weeks.
How are you supposed to stop Schultz? All of a sudden, 3 points. He's the guy leading the back line for the Caps. We've wanted more scoring from the secondary guys and the defense.
You're going to get another one right there for Chris Clark. Off the end boards, and the Capitals have opened the floodgates.
And that means the Moose is coming in. Hedberg will mop up for this Atlanta Thrasher team. Pavlik will head off. Chris Clark. Great to see some of the unsung guys scoring this game. Clarkie gets his first. He's their leader. His first goal since January 1st. The long goalless drought. He was banged up all of last year. Lively boards here in Atlanta. And the Caps have jumped on the Thrashers. They've won some draws this period. Hard shot by Greeny. He'll get the first assist. Hard charging to the net. The captain, Clark. And the Caps, just like that, they're an explosive bunch, Joe, have a three-goal lead.
3 goals in 88 seconds. Ends the evening for Andre Pavlik. He'll give way to the veteran Swede, Johan Hedberg, age 36.
Played just one game this year. He's a great backup. He's a good leader. He's a good guy in the locker room, and that's why they keep him here in Atlanta. He's a tremendous teacher.
Varlamov melts this one. At the other end, though, Hedberg was dynamite in a win over Buffalo. This Atlanta squad, after 5 games straight on the road, watch Chris Clark work around the net.
Yeah, great play by Acoin. Back to Green. Acoin will get his second point. Chris Clark will get his first goal of the season. Cheapy penalty.
Bogosian at the midpoint. Thrasher soon to the power play. Hedberg racing to the bench. Ilya Kovalchuk gloves it down. 6 attackers on for Atlanta. Bogosian elevates for Kovalchuk. Around the stick check of Fair. Through the seam, Bogosian. Enstrom one-timer, toe save by Varlamov. Power play soon to come for Atlanta. They're dangerous, however, with the extra man right now. As that one breezes wide, the Caps go shorthanded.
It's going to be a tripping penalty right to the right of Varley in the Capitals zone. There's a referee going over to center to make the call. Could be a trip or a hook. I think it's going to be a trip. The Caps go to the box. Power play Atlanta. Morrison in the box. Your Verizon Wireless. You make the call here tonight. Here it is off the faceoff. Watch the puck get dumped in deep. Morrison working with the D. There he gets tied up with Maxafin again. Off, takes him down. Went down pretty easy in my mind, and off to the box he goes.
Ilya Kovalchuk at one point. Toby Enstrom the other.
No stick, Joe.
That's not good.
No, he lost it. Broken half off the faceoff.
If they recognize that, when they do, Atlanta should isolate on him. Enstrom. Now seeing 39 without his stick, settles and goes for Kovalchuk, who's got an easy pass to Peverly whenever he likes. Kovalchuk fires, squeezed by Varlamov, and no rebound.
And just on cue for what you said, they were going to isolate on him, and that's exactly what Kovalchuk saw. He saw no long stick at David Steckel, able to shake and move to the middle and get an opportunity. Jeff Schultz, excellent night against Kovalchuk. He's got a three-pointer against the Thrashers here in Atlanta.
Career best, goal and two assists as Antropov digs in on this draw. Washington wins it. David Steckel doing the work. But no clear. Enstrom, Afinagenov, then Kovalchuk. Off the blade of Steckel and off of the rink.
And that's what's so important. Steckel's reach, getting it out in the way of their captain, Kovalchuk, one of the big power play boppers in the National Hockey League. Steckel's working the draws, working the trenches, gets a lot of penalty killing time for Boudreau.
Varlamov gets his first helper. Save total nearing a dozen. You go back to that game that you worked with Al Koch in, the Nashville game. Boy, Steckel, 25 total draws. That's a lot of work.
And he told me this morning, when you look at his blade, it's very flat. It's curved from the heel. He said that gives him a lot of stick on the ice during faceoffs, and that's why he won that last one in his own zone so cleanly. A lot of guys use different curves in the NHL. His is flat, gives him a lot of stick on the ice, and he can utilize his strength.
As Bradley motors in, Matt Bradley, one of three goal scorers here in the second period, as Steckel will play some keep away. If you're watching the game on Comcast Sportsnet, tooling around online, we invite you to go to csnwashington.com. John Sparenberg is the online chat host who covers the Hershey Bears for johnwaltonhockey.com. And he goes way back in the AHL, all the way back to the days in Baltimore with the Bandits and Skipjacks. Peverly feeds for Kovalchuk. They work it around the perimeter. Peverly settles. He has three power play goals already this young season. 47 in the red.
Cleverly or Peverly?
Cleverly Peverly. I like that. And he just inked a nice two-year extension.
And that's a great story considering he started in the East Coast Hockey League, starting in South Carolina.
Kovalchuk, who won't see the ECHL anytime soon, stopped there by Varlamov.
They hope he doesn't see the KHL either anytime soon.
This is Backstrom roaring in, finding Ovechkin. A wrister on the way, well wide of Johan Hedberg, who's taken the net away from Andrei Pavlik, beaten five times in the first 35 minutes.
Did I tell you that Lettinen's your number one guy?
No, you said Pavlik.
I can change my mind, can't I?
You've been prone to do that over the last, 13, 14 years with me? Bjorkstrand on a take back off the boot of Ovechkin. All of this in the grade eight is yet to factor in. Caps on top of the Thrashers on the road. 4:49 to go in period two. 5-2 for the big club.
I'm used to, I call it musical chairs, sliding around everywhere. Eric Fair is going to come up and play with us, and playing with Brendan Morrison is very easy. He controls the puck, and you know where he's going to be, and he makes great reads on the ice. So Eric Fair will come up, be hungry and excited to play, and get his legs under him, shoot the puck, and I think we should have some chances offensively and also play well defensively.
Brooks like prophetic with that Legal Seafoods bite of the night, talking about Eric Fair, who started the scoring spree for Washington this time around in Atlanta. A 5-2 leader as we grow later in period two. Evander Kane wins the foot race and then took a chop from Knubel. Washington's going shorthanded again. Kubina, nice keep in for Hainsey. Those two have been together since training camp. Peverly waved at by Schultz. Ovechkin steals and
scores.
The Caps are a man down.
And scores.
Yes, he does.
How can he do that? I mean, even doing that, touching the puck is amazing, that his backhand goes all the way down the ice. Knubel not happy. He says that's a cheapie. I didn't even hear that all the way up here. Just gave a little love tap on the gloves of Evander Kane. Usually because it's against a rookie, you let him go. That little love tap sends him to the box. I can't believe it. Kane draws a penalty. Power play at
Now we'll see, as you see these power play stats packaged by the UPS store, see if Varlamov and the Capitals defense can hunker down now and not let this one get more and more interesting. Enstrom weaves his way out of his own zone. for Slava Kozlov, who saw Jeff Schultz there, and this is offside against the Thrash.
It's not a pretty entry there. There's Evander Kane. His dad, a former hockey player. His mom also, Joe, I think, a former professional volleyball player. So they come from quite, he comes from quite the athletic family that grew up in Vancouver, Canada.
Genetics are a wonderful thing. And Evander said, you know, I'm still a kid. I like my video games. And he says he's playing lots of the NHL game. I asked
PS3.
Him, yeah. Are you playing yourself a lot? And he says, well, I need to work on my rating. Tell the game operators that. Yeah. Schultz spins it around the wall. Not clear yet. Kubina puts some sauce on that for Kozlov. Slava Kozlov to operate. Straight away, Enstrom. Wrister deflected wide of Varlamov. Cody gets there. Nice look for Steckel. And the Caps are away and clear. Bradley and Steckel 2-on-1. David Steckel stumbles, gets it back and fires, and Hedberg makes the pad save.
He got caught in between thoughts, and then the stick and puck wasn't there. He was looking past to Bradley, then thought second and said, no, I'm going to shoot. And he had too many indecisions there, and that's why they didn't get an opportunity shorthanded.
Maksifin again off for Atlanta, one of their goal scorers on the night. Ilya Kovalchuk the other. Chip and chase for Afinagenov to himself. Keeps it on the wall to point position for Kovalchuk. Calming it down at a point position. Enstrom on the rotation to Afinagenov. Marked by Sean Morrison. Good read by Brooks Like. He pokes it back onto the Atlanta side.
It's hard enough to make that pass on your forehand, let alone your backhand, and that's why Max's pass didn't get through to Kovalchuk.
Sean Morrison ducking the stick of Antropov. Kovalchuk whistles one high. That was rolling and fluttering all the way. Green off the reversal puts it off of the rink. And the faceoff will stay inside. Friends, you can join the fight against prostate cancer. The Caps and Zero are hosting a free screening October 27th, 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. at Verizon Center. No appointment necessary. Simple blood test takes less than 30 minutes. Visit WashingtonCaps.com for more information. October around the NHL, Hockey Fights Cancer Month. As Reasoner and Backstrom, a pair of 19s, face off. We are 2 minutes and change away from a NetStar One intermission report on Comcast Sportsnet. Thorburn barreling into the corner with Pothier to the front. Varlamov made the stick stop. Hainsey yielding some of the ice as Knubel was forechecking. Partnered up with Kubina. Ovechkin stepping in the way of Reasoner, and Atlanta will have to retrace its steps.
That was a good play by OV. He read the play coming up between the two blue lines. So important when you're the top guy to read where they're going. And Ovechkin knows where the puck's going more often than not before it even gets there.
Ilya Kovalchuk has it below the goal line. Three unanswered goals for Washington here in the second period, 1 minute and 28 seconds apart. Changing this game as Schubert fires. It's deflected in front. Loose there. It dribbles into the corner. Five-on-five action continues. Schubert drive deflected down. Knubel has the carom and the clear.
Anderson looking for a late goal here to give some life to his team and the fans here in Atlanta, double shifting the three Russians.
Schultz with that fluke from about 160 feet. Bradley and Clark from right around the cage, giving Washington the three-goal lead in the final minute of the second. Popovic, that was pretty artful to keep in. Looked like a figure skater as Varlamov has this one trapped in his chest protector.
Late pressure by Atlanta Thrashers trying to get that next goal, trying to make this a hockey game. Varley in control along with his Caps team. Very solid, not allowing a whole lot of quality chances here in the second period. Here's that last look right to the belly. Yeah, he looks around a little bit, but he's got it covered. Face off to his left.
Washington playing without the services of Alex Semin this evening. Bruce Boudreau telling us that soreness prevented Alex from making this trip to Atlanta. No word on whether he'll join the team on Long Island for Saturday night. 20 seconds left in this stanza. Heverly makes a move against Sean Morrison. Swings, finds the late guy, and it's blasted wide by Enstrom. Bogosian to Kane. Whoa, low bridge there for Brendan Morrison. 6 seconds left in the period, which treated Washington very well. Toby Enstrom gliding in. Heverly fires as the horn sounds. Done with two in Dixie. The Capitals to the dressing room with three straight goals coming in 88 seconds to take a 5-2 advantage. That's terrific actor, and this young man's having himself a terrific game. Jeff Schultz with a goal and two assists.
3 points tonight, a career high for Schultzy up front. A new guy in the Caps lineup, Brendan Morrison. We highlighted him and Knubel in the show. Well, here's a little closer look at Brendan. 5'11", 185, Hobie Baker, 97, six times 50-plus point scorer. Was an Iron Man at one point, played 542 straight games, loves fishing, boating. And last year when he was dealt to Dallas, his wife lived in Maryland at one point, dealt to Dallas, actually lived with their color guy, Daryl Ray, whose sister he married.
Trying to weave
You're
it all together.
Trying to weave it all together.
And make some brothers-in-law. Yeah. Brendan Morrison, who had an assist in the Nashville win. To my recollection, looking at the scoreboard and score sheet tonight, no points just yet. He's had some good success in his career against Atlanta in the past. Now playing with Washington, his fifth different NHL organization. Back underway, are we? On Comcast Sportsnet in HD tonight, Joe Beninati and Craig Lachlan with you. As this one comes the length of the ice, it's touched up by Bogosian, an icing call against the guys in the white sweaters who hail from our nation's capital.
And there's a look at the Thrashers bench. Not too upbeat. I mean, you get waxed like that in that second period. Not a whole lot of positives to build off of. That's why they were looking for that late goal from someone, especially the Russian three so far here tonight.
Locker, it's the old first home game back after a long road swing.
It's the hardest game. It really is. I mean, they're concerned because they're on a three-game homestand here. They've got the Caps twice.
Nice moves by Armstrong. Stopped by Varlamov. And you know the Capitals want to batten down the hatches and keep this score just the same or improve it. They've had instances where they've coughed up some leads in the third periods in this young season, and it's happened a time or two with Varlamov in goal. You know he wants to be solid in this third. Semyon Varlamov to this point with 15 stops under his belt. Caps in the last four games prior to tonight only allowed 8 goals, so they're playing better defensively.
Yeah, compared to the first part of the season where they allowed 15 the first four games.
5-2 as we're in the second minute of the third. The Moose, Johan Hedberg, has come on. As he goes paddle down to stop Knubel. Knubel, Ovechkin, and Backstrom on ice for the moment. Andre Pavlik was relieved of the netminding duties after he surrendered the 5 goals through 2 periods. Now Green ready to set sail. Next in line for Washington, a trip to Long Island. Venerable Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum.
One of the last teams to get their first win. That against Carolina in a shootout. John Tavares, the eventual game winner. The only team that does not have a win is Ron Wilson's team in Toronto. And they play in Vancouver on Saturday night looking for their first.
Alex Ovechkin cruising in with a drive that was blocked. Hainsey was in the way. Atlanta will host San Jose next up for them on Saturday. Sharp angle bid that's knocked down. Eric Fair started the scoring tonight for Washington on a beautiful send-in from Jeff Schultz.
And I think that's San Jose's last part of their six-game trip, right? Started in Washington, ends up in Atlanta.
They are home. San Jose is with L.A. on the 28th. Long time between home dates and the Shark Tank. Popovic's pass is behind Thorburn. Varlamov will settle, put it on the lip of the boards. Reisner was right there. Sean Morrison digging in. Morrison back in the lineup after missing the win against Nashville. So Tyler Sloan was the healthy scratch on the back line. Alex Semin is out of the lineup for Washington. And we've already addressed, to some degree, Michael Nylander being reassigned and agreeing to a conditioning stint in the American Hockey League in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
He'll get in condition pretty quickly. 3 games in 3 nights, something that he has not seen since being in the NHL.
Green goes full gallop down the wing, drops it to the trailer, Giroux. He also a goal scorer tonight. Set up nicely by Keith Acoin. Those two, an American Hockey League threat whenever they're assembled together in Hershey.
And Acuña has a couple of helpers on that nice pass and off the faceoff win that led to the Clark goal.
Got a penalty call here coming from referee Gord Dwyer. He works with Kyle Raymond. 5-2 Washington on top of Atlanta. Atlanta at 4-1-1, and here's how it's played out.
Started nicely early October in their win here on home ice, 6-3. Went to St. Louis, got a win. Lost to the Ottawa Senators, their only game in regulation as far as the road trip went. At New Jersey, 4-2. At Buffalo, 4-2. And had a real tough loss in Montreal. They played a heck of a game against Montreal and the Canadiens.
Washington's power play hovering around 21%. This fall, getting their fifth opportunity here. Power play stats that are packaged by the UPS store. Washington with a power play goal in every game this season against, except the New Jersey Devils, as this is offside.
Kabina and Ovechkin have been rocking each other all game long. Kabina's been out there on the right side facing Ovechkin this whole game, the matchup they want. His size is his strength. He still moves pretty well for a big guy, but it's all about his size and his physicality that lead Atlanta to get him in the offseason and a big deal with Toronto and have him play as a shutdown guy against Ovechkin in the top forwards in the league.
He's been Atlanta's top guy in terms of ice time in the early going. Second time around for him through the Southeast Division, formerly a long time in Tampa. Evander Kane stashes this one along the boards. Kubina tried to kick it ahead for White. He was tied up by Knubel. Brooks like throws it to the slot. Nobody there for Washington. It's Kane who'll skip it down on Varlamov.
Looking for the same bounce that Schultz got.
If you missed it, Jeff Schultz, back in the second period, near the midway mark, scored from about 15 feet in front of Varlamov on a multi-hopper that skipped past Pavlik like a skimming stone. Green on his backhand for Ovechkin. Sharp angle and through Hedberg wide. Backstrom with those soft hands peels it off the boards. Didn't get it around Peverly the first try. Now Knubel finds Green in tight quarters. 40 seconds on the power play. Peverly able to get it out. Armstrong steers it ahead for Bogosian joining the rush. He drives and scores.
One of the weaknesses we talked about at the top of the show when we looked at both goaltenders who started this game was sometimes inconsistency on the behalf of Varley. Well, here you're going to see an inconsistent play. This is one that he has got to have 100% of the time. There is no in-between. He's got to have that right pad down strong. He's got to have his stick in proper position. Sharp angle shot that Bogosian scores on. And just like that, from a three-goal lead, drops to a two-goal lead after that shot from the wing. That's a shorty for Bogosian.
The first shorthanded goal the Caps have surrendered this season. Atlanta is back within two. Clark, Brendan Morrison, and Fair out there up top for Bruce Boudreau and Dean Evason and Bob Woods. As Varlamov kneels to deny there, Pothier and Pody in back, still with 20 seconds to operate on a power play.
This next save for Varley is going to be of utmost importance to get that confidence back. It can't be a long-range shot. It's going to have to be a tough save. If he does, he's going to be fine the rest of the way here in the third.
Hedberg grabs that loose biscuit long enough for a whistle.
Hedberg, a longtime veteran of the National Hockey League, has bounced around, but he seems to be a steadying force here in Atlanta. One of his big off-season things that he loves to do to stay in condition is play tennis. And he is a heck of a tennis player, playing back home and playing here in Atlanta.
No truth to the rumor that you have a match with him tomorrow?
No truth to that. I would love to be playing tomorrow.
No truth to the rumor that you're staying overnight to see AC/DC here tomorrow night?
I saw them in Washington, the best concert I ever saw. What is it, the Black Ice Tour tomorrow for AC/DC right here? I'd love to, but I'm heading to Long Island.
No truth to the rumor that you are coming back to Atlanta for Miley Cyrus in 10 days?
No, I'm not.
I'm shocked by all of those. As Hainsey nudges it ahead, it's Pothier outlasting Kovalchuk to it. Pody Sweeps it along the boards. Brendan Morrison latched onto by Kubina. This is the dangerous Antropov. High slot. Wrister coming. It was knocked down. Ilya Kovalchuk, a game breaker if there ever was one, was waiting in the weeds.
Took his time on that release, though. He doesn't often take a wrist shot, and that was a wrist shot which allowed Brian Pothier to recover and block that shot.
Alex Giroux, one of the goal scorers for Washington, his came back in the opening period as we are now 6 minutes deep into period three.
Has to be the best tweener in the game right now, Joe.
Yeah.
Has to be the best. I don't think there is anybody else as a tweener, that meaning between the NHL and the American Hockey League, that can step in other than Giroux, who's part of the Caps.
So good at the American Hockey League level, and you say tweener in that it hasn't necessarily materialized for him at this level.
Right.
Matt Bradley in hot pursuit. Enstrom wins that battle, and he'll chase Sean Morrison back into Washington's zone. Morrison talking about Kovalchuk earlier in the day, and that's the word he used, a true game breaker. He can be silent. You don't even notice him out there, and then all of a sudden, wham. And you know that the Thrashers will try to set him up here in the third now, down by two tallies.
Yeah, he's going to have to pull the trigger. There's Peverly, just rewarded. We talked about it in the first period. A two-year, $2.6 million extension Tuesday. His first 73 games with Nash, 20 points. His last 46 with Atlanta, pretty impressive, 44 points. And that led him to be signed here. They like what he brings to the table. He's very quick. He's smooth with the puck. He can be a real nice setup man.
A coin with a good face-off win there. He beat Kovalchuk after Antropov was excused from the dot. Antropov offside, and whoa, a coin went down in a heap. Keith Acoin is almost given up close to what? 8, 9, 10 inches in height against Antropov. As we've played 6 minutes and 42 seconds of this third period. Antropov, meet Acoin, and down you go. Let's see the Ovechkin presented by Ameritel, your hometown place for copiers.
Ovi, a big smile. He usually has a big smile. Tries to feast on the birds here in Atlanta. Good shot right into the belly. Chance and a quick rotation. Draws a penalty from Kubina. And a nice play down low. Backstrom to Ovi. High slot. Just whistles that baby wide. Heavy hit. I said Kubina and Ovechkin have been going at it all night long. Good look at Alex. There's a look at his numbers tonight.
Points in four straight games. Nothing on the board yet for the grade eight this evening as we approach the 7 minute mark of the third. David Steckel fenced in by Schubert. Bradley fires and whoa, Schubert had to duck for cover there. Max Afinogenov flexed it on through for Antropov. Grappling with Pody on the wall. Quinton Lang there defensively, and Steckel will get it out for Washington. First trip for the Caps to Phillips Arena. These two teams see each other six times on the campaign. The next one comes 1 week from tonight. We're right back in here next Thursday. Kubina on a give and go with Antropov, slicing his way through center and not going far. Backstrom and Knubel and Ovechkin out there now. Even strength, full strength. Green lobs it ahead to the veteran Knubel. Indirectly, there's Backstrom. Now Ovechkin fires right to the blocker and glove of Moose Hedberg. More Cadillac tells us the road ahead for Alex and friends.
Head off tomorrow to the island to face the New York Islanders. That'll be Saturday, 7 o'clock start. Al Kokin will do the play-by-play honors. Tuesday covered nationally by our friends at Versus against the Flyers. Thursday back at Atlanta. Home against Friday against the Islanders. And Sunday afternoon, a 5 o'clock tilt on home ice.
A long point drive that was tipped, and Hedberg finds it near the crease.
You look at that schedule upcoming, you'd like to get 4 or 5 wins, Joe. I mean, the Flyers are always tough. Ken Hitchcock seems to have Seabus playing to make the playoffs again this year.
Bruce Boudreau's team would just like to score a goal against Seabus this year.
Shut out twice last year. Wasn't he Rookie of the Year?
That Mason would be Steve Mason.
Yeah.
Caps win the draw again. Sean Morrison plays the wall for Brendan Morrison. No relation. Slava Kozlov right there in the way with Todd White. Turnover, Wrister and Hedberg stepped out, making that save. Brendan Morrison feeds it for Brooks Light. Fair. Didn't thread it through White. Little goes round and round. Bodies are flying. Fair, great move. Had that tipped by the youngster Little. Green off the pump fake. Avoids Kozlov and goes right to the gut of Hedberg.
Good battles by the Caps and Crashers down low on that last sequence. A lot of hard arounds, a lot of wall work, and good battles in front. Kabina and company. Watch Eric Fair. First of all, Light takes a hit to make a play to keep the puck moving forward. Light gets back in the play in front of the net. Fair, a nice dipsy-do. Morrison kept the puck alive. Good cycle, good pressure by the Caps. Eric Fair has been all around the ice, has a goal in this hockey game, and often you get a goal early. You're playing with a ton of confidence, which he has in this game.
More goals for Fair, Locker, against Atlanta than any other team he's faced in his NHL time. He got him four times last year, and he's got one tonight. It started the scoring back in the first.
Sort of like Steckel in Tampa Bay, isn't it?
Right, very good. Here's Bogosian, who had a shorthanded goal this period. Racing up ice, and he ripped that one wide of Varlamov. The Finnegan off to the front. Kovalchuk whistles it wide. Bogosian creeping in to the front for Antropov. Drifting below the goal line, a centering pass that's kicked away by Yurchina.
By the way, I like this line for Atlanta.
Yeah, I think they found something. Bogosian activates, tries to go backdoor. Kovalchuk was tied up by Clark. Well done defensively. David Steckel nearly got past his opposite 39. Instead, it's Antropov and Kovalchuk again. Roaring in. Enstrom was tied up. Caps go shorthanded as two players go heavily to the boards.
And Tom Pody looks like he's going to head off there, taking down Antropov. We got another window of opportunity here tonight, Joe, brought to you by Thompson Creek. Some good opportunities. The ice has been tilted a little bit since that last goal against the Caps. And here's that last thrust coming up the ice. Good opportunity. And there's the play. Take a look at that shortly. 10:23 to go. Power play Atlanta with the Caps penalized again.
Well, they'll have a window of opportunity now on the man advantage for sure. And still boatloads of time in regulation. Better than 10 minutes in this third period. Caps control off the faceoff. Green didn't get it past Kovalchuk. Power play stats that are packaged by the UPS store. Ilya Kovalchuk dancing around Brooks Like. Holds and fires. That hit traffic in front. Rebound loose. Backside. Oh! Kovalchuk missed a layup there. As Varlamov was sprawled out in the crease. Ilya Kovalchuk settles and fires high off the glass, and that will chase Atlanta back into Hedberg's neighborhood.
Didn't you say at the start of the period they've got to have the mentality of putting teams away, Joe?
I did.
It's not been the case here in the third. I mean, they've put their pedal. They haven't had the pedal to the metal, and Bruce Boudreau was talking this morning. He needs a full 60 minutes. Coming into tonight's game, he thought they had put together 51-minute games. They have not played that well here in this third period.
Well, this is obviously a very important penalty kill. They were perfect over the last three games. They killed 12 in a row before Finneganoff scored in the first 6 seconds of Atlanta's first power play tonight. Kovalchuk zigzags and drops it for Toby Enstrom. Into the corner, there's Pody with a nice, simple play.
That's harder than it looked, though, because Pody was number one backpedaling. Number two had to fire that on his backhand, Joe. That's just a great play, as you mentioned.
Got a lot of elevation on it. Peverly angles in. Rich Peverly turns the cooker. Hainsey, or rather a Finneganoff, is stationed along the boards. Kovalchuk straight away. Steps into one and sends it wide. Kubina follows. That was blocked. And the rebound is all the way back down again.
That's 200-mile-an-hour shots in a row. Kovalchuk and then Kabina, and that's why their power play is pretty good here in Atlanta.
Kovalchuk revving it up end-to-end. Hits the brakes, comes back for a Finneganoff, moving to the midpoint. Washington survives that power play. Kovalchuk's blast didn't get through. Yurchina just out of the box, on his way now for a shift change. Just over 8 minutes to go in this third period. The Capitals' advantage is 2 goals. Bogosian has been more and more determined to rush it up ice in period 3. Armstrong's stations it back behind Varlamov. Backstrom and Pothier looking to complete the breakout, and they don't. This is Hainsey. Whoa! Never got to him, and Hedberg was right there on the post. Backstrom. Tight quarters for Ovechkin, and he coughed it up. Briesner ready to set sail. Looking for Evander Kane, and this is offside on the attack. 7:35 to play in period three. Varlamov and the Caps still have the advantage by two.
Some great opportunities against Varley, our Thompson Creek. Window of opportunity. That was a window of opportunity for Atlanta to get back in the game.
7:35 to play in the third. Varlamov has picked up a helper tonight on that crazy Jeff Schultz goal. Schultz partnered up with Brian Pothier. Pothier, nice outlet for Light to hammer one wide. Vander Kane locked up with Eric Fair. And now Popovic will turn. On the hand-ahead, trying to send Kane in on a full thrust. No running room given to him. Schubert pouncing on it for Atlanta. This is Reisner who will turn. The only goal in this third coming from Bogosian shorthanded. Trimming Washington's lead back to two. Mike Green tied up along the wall. This is Armstrong stepping into the attack on the crisscross with Kane. Armstrong shouldered from the blind side. Good work by Brendan Morrison.
Well, he said, you know, he wants to play both sides of the puck, and that's a veteran move by Morrison. Not as big as a lot of guys in the NHL, but positioning critical on the defensive side of the puck. That was perfect.
Steckel drop pass. Bradley with some thunder. Stop, rebound. Trickles right across the goal line.
Steckel, absolutely no luck whatsoever this season. Yeah, he's doing great on faceoffs, but yes, he wants a goal. That baby right off the post.
With Washington in front by a couple, we have this Caps fact presented by American Service Center and Mercedes-Benz of Alexandria, and it deals with Alex.
He loves playing Atlanta. 23 goals, 26 helpers in just 30 games. So he racks them up against the Thrasher Club.
Officially, just three shots on goal for Alex Ovechkin tonight. He must miss Kari Lehtinen, yeah, who has been a personal pigeon for him through the years. Hainsey plays the wing. Good outlet. Nice moves by White. Off the boot of Little. Ryan Little trying to track it down. Varlamov watches this one go wide. There's Sean Morrison to accelerate back through center with 5:40 to play in regulation time.
They've started to open it up a lot more, has Atlanta. That last play, it was actually Kabina backchecking. He's been joining the rush and will continue to do so. So the fourth and fifth guy for the Caps coming back is very important here when they're trying to get this next goal.
Antropov serves it along there for Enstrom, who pivots. Bogosian did keep it in. Bogosian in the slot. Backhander deflected. Varlamov made a pad save there. Enstrom playing catch with the Finneganoff. Even strength here, 5-on-5. Finneganoff lost the handle, and Fair says thanks. He clears it back into the Atlanta zone. Enstrom ready to roll. On a wraparound pass delivery for Finneganoff. Sets the table to Bogosian. Now Kovalchuk off the shin pads of Brooks Light. David Steckel was tripped up, and Washington will get a power play opportunity. That'll help. There's just over 4 minutes to go in the third. The next 2 minutes on the power play for DC on CSN. Here's your Morgan Franklin pivotal play. Locker, you don't see this every day.
No, long-range shot. We'll start it behind the net. Varley drops it off to Schultze. Schultze just trying to get rid of the puck, and look what happens. Good things happen. Double bounce over Pavlik's stick and over Pavlik's left shoulder. Schultze, a nice three-point game here on the road for the Caps.
Follow the bouncing biscuit. Washington wins the offensive zone draw. Green fires. And that hit the screener, Brooks Like. Caps have a power play. Their sixth of the evening. Caps postgame live coming up once we are through from here at Phillips Arena. Al Kokin and Alan May standing by as Chris Thorburn streaks into the attack. Hainsey shoveled that one wide. Capitals have a chance to go 3-on-1 the other way. Ovechkin, backside. Nice defensive work. Backstrom had his bid never get through to the net.
It was hard for Backstrom to pick up that rink-wide pass. The puck was actually in front of him, not behind him, so he had to corral it, then change positions to get the shot away, and by then, it's too late.
Hedberg intercepting Backstrom's dump-in from one Swede to another. Brooks
Light. That's a slash.
Yep, you got it.
Just about broke his ankle down low.
You got it.
Yeah, big Kabina. There it is. I mean, you could hear that baby all the way up here. And Kabina's saying, what, me? Well, that was a two-hander. Brooks, he's lucky to be still standing. Watch the play down low. Here comes. Watch. Two-hand. Boom. Chop down some wood for the winter. And Kabina goes to the box. Big-time 5-on-3 here. Over a minute for the Caps.
And Washington's going to take a timeout. With 3:49 to go.
Gives the Caps training staff to put a cast on Brooksy's foot.
don't even kid. Don't go there. Bruce Boudreau, John Anderson, respective head coaches and very, very good friends. Caps have the advantage by 2. We're early in the season. We're nowhere near the time for free agency, but you're thinking about Ilya Kovalchuk perhaps being available come summertime. There, he could be joined by some top-notch talents.
Including Savard in Boston, who, by the way, is out with a broken foot. Turco, the goalie. Lidstrom, he's not going anywhere. Nabokov, Frolov, Solani, Jokinen, Holmstrom, Marlow, Gonchar, Hamhuis. Some real good players available if their respective teams can't sign them by the July 1st deadline.
Our thanks again go out to John Sparenberg, our online chat host tonight at CSNWashington.com. Capitals on the road in Atlanta, and now with a two-man advantage looking for some insurance. Backstrom waiting, tries the short side. Hedberg was anchored to the post. This one leaves the rink.
Scored on 1 5-on-3 this season. That off the stick of Alexander Semin against the Sharks. There's a look at Backstrom. He's the quarterback out there. Got a lot of talent around him. He's the puck mover and the table setter on their power play.
This one ricochets right to the front. Swept away by Hedberg. Nicholas Backstrom getting a screen from Knubel. A pass that was picked and White will clear. 3:20 to go in the third period. Two-man advantage, 35 seconds. Green for Backstrom. Green, one timer, and that one had a lot of heat on it. It missed the mark. Bodhi for Green, trying to be more precise. Glove save. Two there for Hedberg as he stonewalled Knubel.
It's called simplification of a power play, just getting it to the point and unloading his shots.
Ovechkin straight away. Pody broke his stick and it changed directions and went wide. Ovechkin one-timer, stopped by Hedberg.
Hedberg's been good since he's come in. Real solid. Everything's been hitting him in the belly. Slashing penalty upcoming. It's going to go, I think, against the Caps in this situation.
Hedberg hasn't given up a goal. All five against the starter, Andrei Pavlik. As far as the Caps player of the game is concerned, our Palm Restaurant player of the game, $100 gift certificate for Jeff Schultz.
I like those numbers all around. A goal, a couple of helpers, a +3 tonight. Got his confidence back. Remember, they were platooning the defensive core here in Washington to start the season. 8 NHL D, moving guys in and out of the lineup. He played with Greeny one game, seemed to got his get his confidence back. But all of a sudden, a real good game tonight. A slash penalty to Knubel. That's why the two-man advantage is gone for naught here late.
It's 4-on-4 hockey for about 50 seconds. And still another whistle. 2 minutes for slashing,
17-18. I think they're going to decide here. They're not sure if they got all these penalties right here, maybe. They're talking, the linesman's talking to the referee. The referees are having a huddle here.
Quick conference just inside the Washington D zone. And, of course, there are interested bystanders nearby, the guys in the zebra stripes.
Did that one penalty go away? Yeah, the one penalty went. So it should be 4-on-4. I think we've got it right. I think they're just trying to work that through here.
John Anderson checking it out, looking at the overhead scoreboard. Kubina and Knubel are the only guys in the sin bin at the moment. Gord Dwyer and Kyle Raymond. Kyle Raymond, a Alberta native, one of the younger referees in the NHL, number 37, if you can see him. He's a 31-year-old ref.
Terry Gregson involved now as the head referee in the NHL.
Steve Walcombe came from out of management.
And he's playing
onto the
refereeing again,
back
right?
On the ice as a ref.
Yeah, Terry Gregson, a longtime referee, referee games when I played back in the 80s.
Still unsure of things, the conversation continues. And we can reset it for you. 5-3 for Bruce Boudreau's bunch. This was 2-2 after one. Fair and Giroux on the board for Washington, Afinogenoff and Kovalchuk for the Thrashers. Then the Caps break it open with those three goals in 88 seconds. Schultz, Bradley, and Clark. They had the 5-2 advantage after two. Bogosian's shorty made it 5-3, and you're all caught up as we try to conclude the final 2 minutes and 40-some seconds of this third period.
Yeah, they're going to start this play over because I didn't think Afinogenoff's penalty was over yet anyways. I mean, they had over a minute on the 5-on-3. That's why there was a problem here. So the Caps will have a 4-on-3 here, Joe.
They'll be a long ways away from Moose Hedberg, however. And magically, Afinogenoff has repositioned back in the penalty box.
And they should restart the clock and reset the time. And that's why they're taking a little bit of time here to reset the clocks and the penalties up on the board here in Atlanta.
Capitals Postgame Live will follow us as we've been in HD tonight. Joe Beninati and Craig Lachlan down the stretch. First of six this season between the Caps and the Thrashers. They'll do it again a week from tonight in this very building. In the meantime, Washington goes to Long Island for a Saturday night showdown with the Islanders. San Jose comes in here for Atlanta. Bruce Boudreau continues to speak his piece. And he'll be joined at the bench by referee Gord Dwyer.
And they're not pointing at the clock up here. They're pointing at the clock at the end. So I'm not sure what they're trying to do here. 2:42 shows both on the big clock and the end zone clocks.
Just the second home game of the season for Atlanta.
And what they were just telling Bruce, when Max comes out, because they don't have any time up for his penalty and they want to get this game going. So they're going to count it off at the penalty box with a stopwatch.
Some sort of malfunction. Afinogenoff is out of the box right now and into your picture. Capitals have a heavy advantage when it comes to shots on goal this frame. Yet still, it is Bogosian who has the only tally, one that leaked through Semyon Varlamov. Afinogenoff's wrister, stick save Varlamov. 4-on-4 hockey for another 30 seconds.
Afinogenoff for this Thrasher team has been the best man on the ice for them here on home ice.
He just looks so active when he's into it. When he's skating, you can't take your eyes off of him.
He's got to do it every game.
That's the truth.
That's the big question mark.
That's the truth. Sean Morrison sprinkles this one into the corner. Ahead for Brooks Like. Odd man rush here potential with Brendan Morrison. Morrison closing in, fires, and that's blocked by Enstrom off of the rink.
Indecision there. There's Morrison talking to Enstrom there. A little chit-chat there. Good block of the stick. Getting the stick out was Enstrom on Morrison. Solid game here on the road. Here's a look at that last play. Like to Morrison. He's waiting for Like to jump into the hole. By then, the back checker's next to Like, and he has to shoot. And there, the long windup. Easy deflection by Enstrom.
David Steckel will take this draw. Locker, top five in the NHL in terms of faceoff percentage this month.
And they'll have a power play up coming for the Thrashers here because Kabina comes out and Knubel's still over a minute to go.
And you'd imagine it won't take John Anderson long to pull Hedberg for the extra skater.
Hedberg's motioning over to the bench and right on cue, Joe, on your cue, away he goes. Now it's a 6-man-to-4 advantage for the Thrashers.
David Steckel spins it on out. The good thing is you can take pot shots at the empty goal now because you're a man short. There would be no icing should you miss the net. 1:18 to go in this third period.
Sure taking their time coming up the ice when they have six guys on it.
I didn't see the urgency I expected there.
No.
Back to point position, Kovalchuk. Around Steckel to Antropov. Stepping into a better shooting lane. Kovalchuk bombs away right to the chest. Varlamov off the stop. Rebound off the outside of the post.
Another penalty call is coming.
And this time it's going to be a cross check.
Wow. They've missed the side there. They had twice now in this game. One Kovalchuk and that last opportunity off the blast rang it off the outside of the post. They've been hungry around the net. Might have a timeout up coming here for John Anderson.
Locker, I think both teams have burned theirs.
Have they?
I think okay. both teams have taken theirs.
Okay.
There's I could have swore they did.
I didn't think John Anderson did.
Now they're giving him one.
Yeah.
So obviously he did.
Gets two on home ice.
apparently, in my book.
So now they'll have a 6-on-3. And now they've got a great opportunity. Around the NHL, Joe, some news and notes to ponder and look at. Gonchar, another injury, will miss 6 weeks, missed 56 last year with the shoulder. Mark Savard, long-term IR because of that broken left foot. Sergei Kostitsyn, doesn't look like he's getting along with Bob Gainey, does it?
Not quite.
No.
That would be a no.
Quick goal would make this a game, Joe, wouldn't it?
Yes. There's nobody dressed in the white sweaters who wants to see that happen anytime soon. Less than a minute to play. Washington out shooting Atlanta unofficially 28-22. Beverly lost the draw, but the Atlanta wingers won it, if that makes sense. Enstrom walking the line. Kozlov at the goal line. Pody down. Slapper coming. Score! Ilya Kovalchuk, and the deficit is one.
Just a sloppy third period overall from this Caps team. Well in command, and now they're letting it slip here. Still 38.5 seconds left. I thought they were should have been in a little more of a hurry, but they'll take this, will Atlanta. Kozlov feathers it to the point. D to D, Enstrom, Kovalchuk, bodies in front. That's big Antropov. A screen against Varley, just a wicked slap shot. He shoots a lot like the old Peter Bondra did for the Washington Capitals. When he shoots, Joe, there's everything into the shot. He leaves nothing on the table. He just about corkscrews himself into the ice. He has got them to within one.
That slap shot is lethal. And when you've got a 6'6", 240-pound screen in front of you, awfully difficult for Semyon Varlamov to catch up to that one. But now, it's really interesting. Rashers keep Hedberg on the bench. Washington wins the draw, round and round. Backstrom nudged it for Ovechkin, who's in a wrestling match with Peverly. And there's another penalty call. On who?
I think it's going to be OV for the trip, but we'll see here. I think it's OV. Who got his legs under Peverly right along the boards.
Things have unraveled in the worst kind of way.
Here he is trying to bull rush Peverly. Watch him right there, that left leg. And that's the call. He was trying to overpower him. And I love this new rule. Even though we want the Caps to be successful, the way the faceoff comes to the zone, Joe. In the old days, no, it's outside the zone. Now it comes all the way down, face off, and it remains a 6-on-4.
Seventh power play opportunity for Atlanta. Nail-biting time if you're a Caps fan. Wrister through the screen, knocked down, follow-up. Varlamov the save, rebound! Just batted high by Afinogenov. Kovalchuk finds Enstrom for the blast. Pad save Varlamov. Rebound to the corner. 13 seconds to go. Enstrom switched it up. Kovalchuk closing in. Blocked. Steckel has time. He will clear. And Washington will hang on by a thread.
And Kovalchuk just shaking his head. He can't believe it. He had a chance to tie it up late. Cannot believe it. Right off the faceoff, John. Surprised that Enstrom just didn't shoot it. Because it was a clean win right back to Enstrom. Watch this. Here it is. But instead, he gives it to Kovalchuk. Now, Kovalchuk is the shooter. There's the shot. Look at Max. Two chances for Max Afinogenov. The last one, he can't get it up. He gets it up on the second whack, but up and over the net. Varley and the Caps will escape Atlanta with a one-goal lead.